Google Compute Engine recently announced support for load balancing, allowing you to easily distribute workloads and traffic evenly across two or more virtual machines. I'm now going to show you the process of setting up load balancing across two web servers. Here's the Google Cloud Console, where you can see that I've already created two virtual machines. Both VMs already have Apache web server installed, and I've updated the default web page on both servers to display the name of the server. I've also updated the background color of each default web page to match the name of the server so we can quickly tell which server's page we're looking at to test that everything is working as expected. The other setup step that's already been done is to create a firewall to allow internet requests on port 80. We can see that by going to Networks and selecting our default network. And here under the firewall section, you can see that I've already created a firewall named HTTP1 and that it's set up to allow traffic on port 80. Now let's take a look at the new load balancing feature. There are three sections associated with the feature: target pools, forwarding rules, and health checks. We're about to create a load balanced target pool of multiple servers, so we need to establish a way to confirm that each machine in the pool is working as expected. We can do that by creating a health check under the health check section. We'll click the new health check button to create a health check. For the name, we'll enter basic health check. For the timeout, we'll specify 5 seconds. And for the unhealthy if value, we'll specify 1 consecutive failure, and then click Create to create the health check. And that's done. Now let's create a target pool of VM instances that uses the health check we just created. Start the target pool creation process by clicking the New Target Pool button. We'll name this pool US Central 1 Pool. For the region, we'll select the US Central 1 region, which is where our VM instances reside. Next, we'll add our VM instances to the pool. First the red server, then the blue server. Next, we'll select the health check that we just created, and then click Create to create our target pool. And it's done! One thing to note is that you can edit these target pools on the fly after they are created. So to add more servers to a given pool, all you have to do is create more VM instances and then edit an existing target pool to add the servers. Removing servers is done the same way. And then click Save to save your changes. Now that we've got our target pool created, the last thing we need to do is to create a forwarding rule that will make our target pool accessible at a single IP address. Click the New Forwarding Rule button to create a new rule. We'll name this rule US Central 1 Web. For the region, we'll specify US Central 1, which is where we created our target pool. For the external IP, we have the option to create a static IP address, but we'll go with the default option here, which is ephemeral. For the protocol, we'll specify TCP, which is also the default option. And here's where we can specify a specific port or range of ports to associate with the rule. We'll specify port 80, the default port for HTTP-based web traffic. And here's where we can select the target pool we just created. And finally, we'll click Create to create the rule. And it's done. We've now got a load balanced cluster of two web servers. Let's test it out right now. The only things we need to test it out are a browser and the IP address of the forwarding rule that we just created. So let's copy this IP address and paste it into a new tab and hit enter. And there's the custom default web page for the red server. Now, when I hit refresh, let's see if we get a response from the other web server in our load balanced target pool. And there's the custom default web page for the blue server. Great! The serving load is being balanced between the two servers in our target pool. Let's try it a few more times to see that the load is being distributed on a round robin basis. Now let's stop one of the servers to confirm that the health check for our load balancing pool properly handles the situation and redirects requests to the other server that's still available. We'll go back to the Cloud Console and select VM instances and click on the red server and then scroll down to the SSH link. We'll copy that SSH command and jump over to a terminal window to run it. We're now logged on to the instance. Let's stop the web server. Here's the command we'll run to stop Apache. We'll start by typing sudo to run the command as superuser, then the location of the Apache service, followed by the stop command. Let's run that. And the Apache web service on this instance is now stopped. Let's go back to our target pool and see how it responds to this change. And here we can see that the health check for the red server is showing that it's unhealthy. Our target pool now only contains one healthy VM instance, Blue Server. So if we go to the browser where we were previously sent the default page of the red server, we should be able to reload the page and be redirected to the Blue Server without skipping a beat. Let's do that now. Here's the browser window where we were previously forwarded to the red server. When I click reload, yes! We just got forwarded to the Blue Server, which is the only healthy VM that's still available in our load balancing target pool. Let's try it a few more times. You can see that we're consistently being routed to the healthy server in our target pool. Excellent. I've shown you a very simple example of using load balancing on Compute Engine. In addition to using the Cloud Console to set up load balancing, we also offer a command line tool and RESTful APIs so that you can integrate load balancing directly into your code. Load balancing on Compute Engine is highly scalable, so you can confidently create multiple target pools, forwarding rules, and health checks. Best of all, our load balancing requires no manual pre-warming, even when you anticipate significant traffic spikes. As you've just seen, it's simple to set up a cluster of load balance web servers on Compute Engine, and it's easy to customize the setup to meet your needs. Thank you for watching.